Dear viewers of Akti.com, by Vetri from Pondicherry. Good evening. Today, I am going to discuss another most important chapter, Hydrocarbon. What is hydrocarbon? Let me define. Hydrocarbons play a key role in our daily life. The term hydrocarbon means compounds of carbon and hydrogen only. So, hydrocarbon means compounds containing carbon and hydrogen. Hydrocarbons are of different types. Depending upon the types of carbon-carbon bonds present, they can be further classified into three main categories, namely 1. Saturated hydrocarbon, 2. Unsaturated hydrocarbon, and 3. Aromatic hydrocarbon. So this is the most important information. Okay, let me give you. So what is under the hydrocarbon? So let me consider the first one is alkanes. What is alkane? Saturated hydrocarbons contain carbon-carbon and the carbon-hydrogen single bonds. So they are called alkanes. So alkanes are nothing but saturated hydrocarbon. The members are methane, CH4, ethane, CH3, CH3, propane, CH3, CH2, CH3, and going on, butane, pentane, hexane, heptane, octane, nonane, decanes going on. So these are the members under the alkane family. Okay, next. I have to discuss under this the most important the concept that is homologous. Each and every type of organic compound, this homologous series is most important. What is homologous series? Homologous series is a group or class of organic compounds having same general formula, same general method of preparations, same physical and chemical properties, and their success members differ by CH2. This is the most important characteristic of homologous series. Let me repeat again. Homologous series is a group or class of organic compounds having same general formula, having same general method of preparation, having same physical and chemical properties, and the successive member differ by CH2. Okay, let me explain in detail of this. First one. Let me discuss the characteristic of homologous. First one is all members of homologous series contain same elements and the same functional group. That is the first characteristic. So under the alkane, here specifically I have taken methane and ethane. Molecular formula CH4 and ethyl molecular formula CH3CH3. So both compounds contain same elements. That is carbon and the hydrogen. The another interesting information here, the same functional group that is not applicable here because there is no functional group present in alkane. This is the most important. So, in this specifically, the first characteristic is carbon and hydrogen is present. Okay, let me go for the second characteristic under the homologous series. All members of homologous series contain same general formula. Same general formula. Specifically, under this alkane, alkane is having a general formula CnH2n+2. Suppose if n equal to 1, this formula will correspond to methane. Suppose if n equal to 2, then it will indicate ethane. So this is the second characteristic, the most important. So all members of homologous series contain same general formula. Okay, the third characteristic. All members of homologous series show similar physical properties. And these physical properties will increase with increase in molecular mass. This is another most important characteristic. So, specific example under this. So, I am giving the boiling point of three members. Methane, the boiling point is a gas actually. So, that's why the boiling point is given in the form of minus. Minus 161.5 degrees centigrade. Ethane, minus 86.6 degrees centigrade. And propane, minus 42.1 degrees centigrade. So the molecule, the boiling point increases with increasing molecular weight. This is the characteristic of tomoglycoside. The fourth characteristic. All members of homologous show similar chemical properties. Similar chemical properties. A specific example under the alkene. So all alkene undergo halogenation to produce corresponding haloalkane. This is the most important. So it's same general chemical properties. So specifically here, so a little bit, you know, methane undergo halogenation in presence of sunlight to produce methyl halide and HS. The same ethane undergo halogenation to produce ethyl halide. So more specifically, if you want to say, we can even go for halogenation, that is, under the halogenation, we can use chlorine. So when you use chlorine, methyl chloride, methylene chloride, chloroform, and carbon tetrachloride form. The same when you take ethane, so ethyl chloride, one, that is, one chloroethane, one comma two dichloroethane, etc., will be formed. So the next one, fifth characteristic. All members of homologous series can be preferred with same general method of preparation. This is another most important characteristic. All members of homologous series can be preferred by same general method of preparation. Specifically here, all alkenes can be preferred from corresponding alkenes by reduction, simply by passing hydrogen in presence of suitable catalyst. So ethylene, addition of H2 in presence of nickel will get now ethene. The same way, propylene by addition of H2 in presence of suitable crystal, that is the catalyst, will get to propane. So any alkene can be prepared corresponding from alkene by passing hydrogen in presence of suitable catalyst. This is, so all members of homologous series can be prepared the same general method of preparation. The next, another important characteristic. All successive members of homologous series differ by CH2 group. So successive member differ by CH2 group. Specifically in this case, methane, CH first member, CH4. Ethane, CH3, CH4. That means this is CH4. The second one is C2H6. The difference will be CH2. The same, if you compare this propane and ethane, again the difference will be CH2. So the successive members will differ by CH2 group. This is another characteristic of homologous series. The next, let me consider what are the topics to be studied under the alkenes. This is general for any chapter in organic chemistry. So these are the topics we have to concentrate. Whether it is hydrocarbon, under the hydrocarbon alkane, alkene or alkynes, or alcohol, aldehyde, ketone, acid, anything. So these are the topic to be discussed. So under this also hydrocarbon, so number one is classification. Number two, naming. Under the naming, common name and IUPAC. Three, isomerism. Four, preparations. And five, properties. And six, uses. So these are the topic to be covered in unit chapter. So let me concentrate on alkanes. So first let me discuss classification. So generally, I can now, under the classification, let me take commonly hydrocarbon. So hydrocarbon, I can broadly classify into open chain compound and closed chain compound. Open chain specific example, XA, and closed chain specific example, cyclo-XA. This is the first way I can classify broadly. Then, I can go for then, open chain, I can further classify into two types. One is saturated, another is unsaturated. Under the saturated specific example, first member methane and ethane, propane, butane is going on. Under the unsaturated compound, again further I can classify into two types. One is alkene, another is alkyne. I can further classify unsaturated into two types. One is alkene containing double bond, alkynes containing triple bond. The specific example I want to give here. So ethylene coming under this alkene, acetylene coming under the alkyne. This is the specific example. Okay. And next, let me go for the next one. So, before entering the next step, first let me discuss how to differentiate alkanes, alkenes, and alkynes. Let me discuss because commonly question can be asked under this. So, specifically, if you want, I can say nothing but ethane, ethylene, and acetylene. So instead of saying generally is alkane, alkene, alkyne, specifically ethane, ethylene, and acetylene, how to differentiate? Let me discuss now. So there are four important tests to differentiate this alkane, alkenes, and alkynes. First one, action of bromine. So now what you have to do now, take three test tubes and just pass the gas in front of water. So gas is dissolved in water. Now what you can know, first case, so add bromine water in all the three tubes. What will happen to the first tube? In the case of alkane, no decoloration. In the case of alkenes, undergoes decoloration. In the case of alkynes, again undergoes decolorization. So only alkanes will not undergo decolorization, whereas alkene and alkyne will undergo decolorization. So what is happening actually? The double bond and triple bond will be saturated by bromine. That's in the first one. Right. Second, action of potassium permanganate, another important reagent we can use to differentiate alkane, alkene, and alkyne. Again, in the case of alkanes, no decolorization. Whereas in the case of alkenes and alkynes, undergoes decolorization. So again, the potassium permanganate will be able to differentiate the alkane from alkenes and alkynes. And third most important test is action of ammonium silver nitrate. Silver nitrate dissolved in ammonium hydroxide, we'll call it as ammonical silver nitrate. So if you add ammonical silver nitrate on the three test tubes, the interesting information, in the case of alkane, there is no characteristic precipitate. No precipitate is formed. The same way alkene, again there is no characteristic precipitate. But in the case of alkynes, a white precipitate will form. It is due to silver acetylide. This is the most important information. It is due to the silver acetylide. So actually what is happening, let me take a specific example, acetylene. So when you treat with ammonical silver nitrate, that is, we'll call it as ammonical silver nitrate is nothing but tollens reagent. We'll call it as tollens reagent. So what will happen now? The terminal hydrogen, which is acidic in nature, will be replaced. So we are getting this silver acetylide will form. Silver acetylide will form. This is the precipitate that is formed. Can you follow? A white precipitate will form. So the hydrogen that is present in this acetylene will be acidic in nature, that can be replaced by this. This is the most important reaction. The same way, the fourth test. So what happened now? Only alkyne will answer, at alkyne containing terminal C triple bond CH. Whereas alkanes and alkenes will not answer. The same fourth test, action of ammonical cuprous chloride. Again. So cuprous chloride again. So again we'll add in all the three tests too. So alkanes, no characteristic precipitate. Alkenes, no characteristic precipitate. And again alkyne, a red precipitate is formed. This is the most important information. Can you follow? The red precipitate is formed in the case of the correspondingly acetylene is present. That means a terminal C triple bond CH. So what happened now? In this case, again CEC, that is corresponding C triple bond C, again copper. So this is the red precipitate. So this is the characteristic. So this is the most important information regarding this test. So the idea here it is, so first two, action of bromine water and action of potassium permanganate, will be able to differentiate alkane from alkene and alkynes. Whereas third test, action of ammonical silver nitrate and action of ammonical cuprous chloride will differentiate alkyne from alkene and alkynes. So all the three can be differentiated by the fourth test. Okay, let me go for the next one. So, coming under the classifications, so closed chain, I can further classify into aliphatic or aromatic. This is another most important. So, if close the specific example under the aliphatic, cyclohexane under the hydrocarbon, and aromatic specific example is benzene. Right. Even under the benzene, so now let me go for the next is, can you follow? Aromatic again, I can further classify into monocyclic and there is polycyclic. Monocyclic, I already specific example benzene. Polycyclic, naphthalene, phenanthrene, etc. Okay. Now, here I want to give one more information, that is, how to differentiate an aromatic compound from aliphatic. This is another most important commonly question will be asked. how to differentiate the aromatic compound from alkyl. So I can say theoretically as well as practically. So practical, a point of view I will discuss now, three important tests. One is solubility in water, I can differentiate. Number two, combustibility. Number three, nitration, or more specifically qualified, it is the electrophilic substitution reaction. Okay, so what is solubility in water? Generally, aromatic compounds are insoluble in water, whereas aliphatic compounds generally soluble, specifically wine numbers. So from the solubility, you can be able to differentiate aromatic and aliphatic. Number two, combustibility also we can be able to differentiate aromatic compound from aliphatic. So generally aromatic compound burn with the smoky flame or sooty flame, whereas aliphatic compound burn without smoky flame. How to identify? Technical spatula and your aromatic or aliphatic compound show over the flame. If it is aromatic, burn with the sooty flame. If it is aliphatic, burn without sooty flame. Very easily they can be able to differentiate. The reason probably, when we are using aromatic compound, it is containing the carbon content higher, so carbon dioxide will be more. That may be the reason. But coming to the nitration, that is under the substitution reaction. So generally, aromatic compound give yellow color solution or precipitate during nitration, whereas aliphatic compound give colorless solution. So very easily, we can be able to differentiate aromatic from aliphatic by these three tests. The next we have to go for the theoretically. Theoretically, how to identify an aromatic compound? Suppose I want to differentiate cyclohexane from benzene. How to differentiate? Because this is cyclohexane, this is benzene. So cyclohexane is aliphatic, benzene is aromatic. How to differentiate? So to be aromatic, your molecule must have, kindly follow, number one, have a planar ring or rings. So benzene is aromatic, we know. So this containing one aromatic ring. Now number two, have a conjugation. What do we mean by conjugation? Conjugation means alternatively single and double bond should be there. You take benzene ring, that is here single bond, double bond, single bond, double bond, single bond, double bond. So it is having conjugation. The third condition, you should have sp2 hybridization, because if you look into the benzene ring, in each case the hybridization is sp2, 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 sp2. So in all the carbon there is sp2 hybridization. So this also one of the most important condition to be aromatic. Then Obey-Hückel's rule, that is another most important. What is meant by Hückel's rule? The according to Hückel's rule, to be aromatic, a molecule should contain 4N plus 2 pi electrons. 4N plus 2 pi electrons. Where the N is nothing but an integer starting from 0. So both N equal to 0, the total number will be 2. N equal to 1, total number will be 6. It's going on 2, 6, 10, 14, 18, 22, like this. So to be aromatic, the molecule should contain these pi electrons. The one most precaution here it is, beyond 22 pi electron, even if it is the Hückel's rule, it is not aromatic, it is due to the non-planarity. Okay, so you should obey Hückel's rule. The next one, should show extra stability due to different resonance structure. Due to different resonance structure, that is the most, what resonance? So benzene exists in two forms, one is here, this is the one resonance structure. Another resonance structure is this. Then you follow 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Between 1 and 2 single bond, here between 1 and 2 double bond. So it is having two resonance structure. So if it can be generally represented by this way, this is the way we have to represent general formula. So the extra stability due to the resonance structure, different resonance structure. And finally, it will be a characteristic spectroscopic signal in NMR. H1 NMR, proton signal, and between, that is 6 to 8 BPM. And in carbon C13 NMR, and again between 120 to 140 BPM, will have a characteristic signal. It shows again aromatic. So these are the characteristic of aromatic. So theoretically, we can be able to identify to be aromatic if you satisfy these all six conditions. Okay, let me go with this. Let me go for the next is the correspondingly nomenclature under the alkenes. Let me take specifically alkenes under this nomenclature. So nomenclature means naming. So naming we can do by two ways. One is common name, another is IUPAC. So common name we can give by three ways. From source we can give common name. From the nature of carbon chain we can give common name. From the nature of the position of the functional group we can give common name. But the third one is not suitable here in that of the alkane. So only two types possible based on the source. So for example, methane is commonly called a marsh gas. It is common name. This is one way from source. The other most important thing, from the nature of the carbon chain also will give common name. Let me discuss now. So common name here, CH4, methane common name, again ethane common name for the correspondingly in the ethane. Let me now, based on the nature of the carbon chain, so this is the formula for N-pentane. I'm using common name N-pentane. N-pentane, 5 carbon atom, a linear chain. Without any branches, I will use, count the number 5, so I will call it as N-pentane. Suppose. So, I will use another name is common name, isopentane. When I will use isopentane? If any linear chain, there is a branch chain, and under the branch chain, the second carbon atom is having a 1 methyl group, I will use the term isopentane. So, this is called isopentane because there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbon atoms. The second carbon atom from the right, there is a methyl group. So whenever a methyl group is present in the second carbon atom, either from left or from right, I will use the word isopentane. Same way, if two methyl groups are present in the second carbon atom, I will use neo. So in this case 5, so I will use neopentane. So this is the common name for, so N-pentane, isopentane and neopentane are common name for alkanes. So let me go for the IUPAC name. IUPAC, what is IUPAC? International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. For all the rules, kindly refer my previous lecture. Under the IUPAC rules, you can get a clear idea. So let me just give, for the time sake, I will give the name. So, CH4, I will call IUPAC name methane. CH3, IUPAC name ethane. And this one, 5 carbon atoms, CH3, CH2, 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 CH3, will give name pentane. So simply, methane, ethane, propane, butane, pentane, they are called IUPAC names. But if you use N or iso or neo, it is coming under this common name. This is the most important information. Okay, let me go for the next one. So under this, kindly follow. Again, complicated structure, I am going to give a IUPAC. So, simple example, I have given the IUPAC. So, a little complicated, so I am giving IUPAC name. Kindly follow, this is again the following rules. This is called the pentane, 5 carbon atom. So, in this case, the common name I have already discussed, this is called isopentane. The corresponding IUPAC name is 2-methyl butane. 1, 2, 3 and 4. It is in the second carbon atom that is a methyl group. I will call it as 2-methyl butane. So now coming for, in this case, common name is 2, there is common name is a neopentane. The neopentane can be named as 2,2-dimethyl propane. That is IUPAC name for this. This is the interesting information. So let me go for the next is the correspondingly isomerism. I will discuss isomerism in alkene. First, what is isomerism? Compounds having same molecular formula but different physical and chemical properties are called isomers, and the phenomenon exhibited by this isomer is called isomerism. So isomerism can be broadly classified into two types. One is structural isomerism, another is stereoisomerism. Structural isomerism can be further classified into four types: chain, positional, functional group and metabolism. Stereoisomerism can be further classified into two types. One is optical, another is geometrical or system isomerism. So now under out of these six isomerism, only two isomerism are possible in alkane. Let me concentrate only these two. So if you want to get more information, kindly refer my isomerism the lecture. So out of six, only two isomerism possible under alkane is chain isomerism and there is optical isomerism. So let me discuss only these two. So under the chain isomerism, a specific example I am giving here, butane and 2-methyl propane are specific examples of isomerism. This is coming under chain isomerism. Or common name I want to give, N-butane and isobutane. N-butane and isobutane are specific examples of chain isomerism. The corresponding I-pair name is butane and 2-methyl propane. Because one is linear chain, another is branched chain, so they are structurally different. So what is chain isomerism? Compounds having same molecular formula, but difference in arrangement of carbon chain are called chain isomer, and the phenomenon exhibited by this chain isomer is called chain isomerism. So they are structurally different in chain arrangement, that's why it's called chain isomerism possible. So chain isomerism is possible in alkanes. The same way, let me go for the next one is, another one is optical isomerism. So what is optical isomerism? Compounds having same molecular formula but difference in optical activity are called optical isomers, and the phenomenon exhibited by this optical isomer is called optical isomers. Normally, the compound containing asymmetric carbon atom will show optical isomerism. So in this case, all alkanes will not show specifically, but optical isomerism is possible in all types of organic compound. The specific example here I have used, that is 3-methyl hexane is optically active. Just see here, this is what way? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Under 3, that is the methyl group. So 3-methyl hexane is optically active because 4 different. So methyl group, hydrogen, ethyl group, and propyl group, all the 4 different. So it is optically active. So normally, this will exist in 2 forms. Can you follow? Now I will show you now. So this is one form. Theoretically, I can use the word now, R configuration, another is S configuration. So, this is according to Kahn-Hilbert-Prelog's rule, number 1, number 2, this is number 3. So, it moves clockwise, so configuration is R. The same way, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is moving anticlockwise, so this is S. So, it will exist in 2 forms. So, 3-methyl hexane exists in 2 forms, one is R form, another is S form. So, if you measure optical activity, one will be plus, another will be minus. So, these 2 forms are called enantiomers. So the idea here it is, optical isomerism is possible in alkanes, specifically suitably substituted alkanes. Okay, let me go to the next one. So let me concentrate on preparation of alkanes. Preparation of alkanes, let me concentrate. So I can prepare alkanes from a number of compounds. Let me go systematically, one by one. First, from alkenes, I can prepare any alkane I want. A specific example here, the name reaction is Sabatier-Sandrance reduction, the name reaction. So general method, RCH double bond CH2 undergo reduction in presence of hydrogen, in presence of nickel at 200 to 300 degrees centigrade will give the corresponding alkane. This is called Sabatier-Sandrance reduction. So specifically, so I can take now, ethylene undergo reduction by passing hydrogen in presence of nickel at 200 to 300 degrees will produce ethane. The same way, propylene by passing hydrogen in presence of nickel at 200 to 300 degrees will produce propane. Can you follow? So any alkane can be prepared from corresponding alkane by Sabatier and Sandrance reduction. This is the first method. The second method, from alkynes also, I can prepare alkanes. General method here I am saying, any alkyne, RC triple bond CH, by passing nitrogen in presence of nickel, again the temperature 200 to 300 degree, the corresponding alkane, RCH2CH3. So specifically, let me take now, acetylene, by passing 2 moles of hydrogen in presence of nickel, at the temperature 200 to 300 centigrade, I am getting ethane. Same way, if I take propyl, the same conditions, I will get now propane. So from alkane also, I can prepare alkane. This is the second method. Now third method. From alkyl halides, I can prepare. From alkyl halides, I can follow different methods, different conditions, I will prepare alkanes. The first one is, by metallic reduction, I can use alkyl halide, I will get correspondingly alkanes. Here, I will use the reagent, zinc and SCl, or ethyl alcohol and sodium, or the phosphorus and potassium H-ion, lithium aluminum hydride. Any reagent I will use for that action. Okay, so general method is RCH2X, by using any one of above reagent, so hydrogen will be added, the corresponding alkane RCH will be produced along with H-ions. So specifically, methyl chloride will undergo reduction to produce methane and HCl. Same way, ethyl chloride undergo reduction to produce ethane and HCl. So, any member I can prepare from the correspondingly take suitable alkyl halide by using any one of these reagents. So, I will call it as metallic reduction. I can prepare suitable alkyl. But this is method, third method A. Then, under the third method, I will go for the B by Wood's reaction. This is the name reaction. The most important commonly question will be asked. The general method is, generally, 2 moles of alkyl halide in presence of 2 moles of metallic sodium and dry ether will produce an alkane. This is general. So, this is the general method of Wood's reaction. Any alkane we can prepare. But this method, Wood's reaction, is suitable only for alkane containing even number. So, specifically, let me take example. Methyl bromide, 2 moles. Reacts with the 2 moles of metallic sodium in presence of dry ether, it is already given condition. So we are getting now ethane. So what here? So this will be getting eliminated in the form of sodium bromide. So I am getting ethane from methyl bromide. The same way, 2 moles of ethyl bromide reacts with again 2 moles of metallic sodium in presence of dry ether again, I can get correspondingly butane. The interesting information is, kindly follow, this method is suitable for the preparation of higher alkane containing even number of carbon atoms. So this method is not suitable for odd number. Why? The reason is very simple. Suppose I want to prepare propane, even odd number, what I have to use now? Suppose my aim is I want to prepare propane. What I have to use? I have to use methyl bromide plus sodium 2 moles plus ethyl bromide. So this is the reagent I have to use, and I have to use again dry ether. In presence of dry ether, I have to combine. So what will happen now? I am expecting propane. This is the product I am expecting. But what will happen additionally? 2 moles of methyl bromide will combine to produce ethane, and same way, 2 moles of ethyl bromide will combine to produce butane. The problem here it is, my aim is I want to prepare propane, but additionally 2 more products I am getting. I am getting ethane, I am getting butane. So this method is not suitable to prepare alkane containing odd number. This is suitable only for even number. That's why I have indicated. Okay, and next one. Under the halides, again by using suitable Krikenaud reagent, I can prepare any alkanes. What the Krikenaud reagent? The general is RMGX is the general formula for Krikenaud reagent. By treating with water in presence of dry ether, again a suitable hydrocarbon RH can be produced along with the MGX and OH. Specific example. So methyl magnesium iodide reacts with the water in presence of dry ether give methane and MgOHI. But what will happen now? This MgI and the correspondingly OH will be taken. So the CH3 combined with hydrogen will produce methane. So whatever alkyl part we are using for Krikenaud reagent plus addition of hydrogen will give the corresponding alkane. So if I take methyl magnesium iodide, methane. Ethyl magnesium iodide, I will get ethane. So same if you can even go for aromatic compound, the phenyl magnesium iodide will give the benzene. So the interesting information is, any alkane I can prepare by using suitable Krikenaud reagent. Okay, let me go to the next one. The next method is, from alcohols, carbonyl compounds and the carboxylic acid also we can prepare suitable alkanes. So here, the specific reagent here it is, that is phosphorus in presence of HI at a higher temperature, 150 degrees centigrade. The general method here it is, ROH, general formula for alcohol, 2 moles of HI to give RHI2 and H2O. Specifically, methanol reacts with the 2HI to give methane, I2, iodine and H2O. The same ethyl alcohol will produce correspondingly ethane. So from alcohol, I can prepare corresponding alkane. The same way, The next one is from aldehyde also I can prefer suitable correspondingly alkane. Then the guide activity is the general method is RCHO reacts with the 4 moles of HI to produce correspondingly inverse of the phosphorus at 150 degree centigrade RCH3 2I2H2. Now specific method, specifically formaldehyde reacts with 4 moles of HI to give methane, 2 moles of I2 and H2O. The same if you use acetaldehyde, I will get correspondingly ethane. So depending upon the nature of the aldehyde, I can get correspondingly alkane. This is the interesting thing. Same way, I can prepare alkane from the corresponding keto. So from ketone also I can prepare alkane. It's a specific example. So this is the general method. RCOR, 4 moles of HI in presence of red phosphorus, again 150 degree centigrade, RCH2R. That is the product form. That means that under the carbon element, see, O is going out and two hydrogen atoms coming in. So 2 moles of I2, the H2O is formed. The specific method, so acetyl-1O reacts with 4 moles of HI under the phosphorus at 150 degree, I am getting propane. So acetyl gives correspondingly propane along with the 2 moles of I2 and H2O. So from ketone also, I can prepare alkanes. The next one, from acid also, I can prepare. What is the general? RCOOH reacts with the 6 moles of HI in presence of phosphorus, 200 to 250 degrees, it is slightly higher temperature. The corresponding alkene RCH3, so 3I2 and 2H2O. Specific example, and then acetic acid, CH3COOH, and 6 moles of HI in presence of phosphorus, at 200 to 250 centigrade, I am getting ethane, so 3 moles of I2, 2 moles of H2O. This is the interesting information. So ether I am getting from acetic acid. This is the most important information. So from acid also I can prepare suitable alkane. The next most important is the method 5. From sodium or potassium salt of fatty acid, I can prepare alkane. The method is called decarboxylation. It's called decarboxylation. So decarboxylation of fatty acid using soda lime. What is soda lime? It's a mixture of sodium hydroxide and calcium oxide, is called soda lime. This is the most important information. So when you treat, general method is RCOONA, when you treat the sodium hydroxide in presence of calcium oxide, so corresponding alkane produced along with sodium carbonate. This is the most important thing. Specifically, sodium acetate reacts with sodium hydroxide with the calcium oxide to produce methane and sodium carbonate. So depending upon the nature of sodium salt, the corresponding alkane will be produced. If I take sodium benzene, I will get benzene, which is the interesting information. So this is the most important method is decarboxylation is the most important method. I can prepare alkane. The next other most important method is electrolysis of sodium salt of fatty acids. I can, the main reaction is called Kolff's electrolytic method or Kolff's electrolysis. The general is 2 moles of RCO, okay, by passing electric current, I am getting RR, 2 moles of carbon dioxide, 2 moles of K. Specifically, I can take 2 moles of potassium acetate, so I am getting ethane and 2 moles of potassium, 2 moles of carbon dioxide. So potassium acetate, from potassium acetate, I can prepare ethane. The another interesting method is, this method is suitable for the preparation of even number of alkanes. That actually, the 2 CH3 combined to produce corresponding ethane. This is the interesting information regarding the preparation. Now let me come for the properties. Under the properties, I have to discuss physical property and there is chemical properties. Under the physical properties, the first 4 members of alkanes are gases. Methane, ethane, propane and butane are gases. The next 13 members are liquids and the remaining members are solid. This is the most important information. Lower numbers are gases, higher numbers are liquid, still higher numbers are solid. The other most important regarding physical properties, branched chain alkane generally have lower boiling point than corresponding straight chain alkane. This is due to the surface area. So specific example, N-pentane, it is minus 36.1 degree, whereas isopentane minus 27.9 degrees. This is the interesting information. So, let me go for the next one. Coming for chemical properties, alkanes are relatively less reactive towards many common reagents at room temperature. They are less reactive, chemically enough. So they do not react with the acid like HCl, sulfuric acid, bases like sodium hydroxide and KOH, and also off-reactive agents like potassium permanganate, etc. They are less reactive. However, they will do some reaction. So reactions of alkene can be broadly classified into two types namely. So let me discuss under the two headings. One is substitution reaction, another is thermal and catalytic reaction. I will discuss under the chemical property. First let me take substitution reaction. So under the substitution reaction, first I will discuss halogenation. What is the general method? Any alkene reacts with a halide in presence of light, will produce the corresponding halide and HS. Specifically, in this case, the order of reactivity will be, fluorine will be more reactive than chlorine, than the bromine, than iodine. The interesting information here, when we are using iodine, what will happen? HI will form. The HI is a strong reducing agent, so this method is not recommended for direct iodination. In that case, the special name reaction we are using, that is called Finkelstein reaction. So if you, whenever you want to prepare any alkyl iodide, use Finkelstein reaction. What you have to do now? So you take corresponding alkyl chloride and then treat with the sodium iodide in presence of acetone, you will get correspondingly alkyl iodide and two moles of sodium chloride. This is the specific method. The method is called Finkelstein reaction. It's a specific method whenever you want to prepare alkyl iodide, because direct iodide we cannot prepare. This is the most important information. So let me give a specific example to understand this concept. So specific method, methane reacts with the chlorine presence of sunlight, that is UV light, to give correspondingly methyl chloride and HCl. So methyl chloride further reacts to give methylene chloride. Methylene chloride further reacts to give chloroform, and chloroform further reacts to give carbon tetrachloride. The final product will be carbon tetrachloride. The methyl chloride, methyl chloride and chloroform are intermediates. This is the, so depending upon the concentration of chlorine, so the different products are formed. This is the most important information regarding halogenation, specifically chlorination. Next, let me go for the nitration. What is the common nitrating agent? Nitric acid. Generally, when you treat nitric acid in vapor phase, any hydrocarbon will give correspondingly nitrate, alkyne nitrate, or nitroalkane. So, specifically, RH reacts with nitric acid to give RNO2 plus water at higher temperature, 400 to 500, that meets almost in vapor phase. The specific example, methane reacts with nitric acid at the higher temperature to produce nitromethane. This is the most important under the nitration. Next, let me go for sulfonation, another most important reaction under the alkane. So, under the sulfonation, generally we are using sulfuric acid, H2SO4, sulfonating agent. So when you treat any alkane corresponding to sulfuric acid, the corresponding sulfonic acid is from RSO3H will form. Specifically, so let me give you now, methyl reacts with sulfuric acid, methyl sulfonic acid water is formed. So if it is ethyl corresponding, ethyl sulfonic acid. Okay. Now next let me go for another most important, chlorosulfonation. Specifically, any alkane reacts with sulfur dioxide and chlorine in presence of light, UV light, we are getting correspondingly RCH2SO2, that is corresponding thiol chloride is formed, or sulfonyl chloride is formed. So specific example, ethane reacts with sulfur dioxide and the chlorine in presence of light to produce corresponding ethyl sulfonyl chloride, CH3CH2SO2Cl, ethyl sulfonyl chloride and corresponding HCl is formed. This is the most important under the chlorosulfonation. Next, let me discuss thermal and catalytic reaction. Let me discuss one or two. Under this, I will say oxidation, or I can say combustion reaction. Any alkane reacts with oxygen to produce correspondingly final product will be carbon dioxide water. So RCH3, 2O2 gives CO2 and 3H2O, and energy will be released. So, what will happen now, depending upon the nature, energy may be absorbed or released. Kindly follow here. In this case, specific example, methane reacts with 2 moles of oxygen to produce carbon dioxide and 2 moles of water, along with the energy that is 213 calories will be absorbed. The interesting information, the heat of combustion increases with the molecular rate. This is the most important information under this combustion. Next one, pyrolysis or cracking. This is another most important method, the property of alkanes. So any alkanes generally applicable for higher alkanes. But when you heat at a higher temperature, 5 degrees centigrade, we'll get to alkanes and the alkenes will get a mixture. This is the characteristic. More specifically, let me give an example. Suppose if I take 3 moles of ethane, when I heat at a higher temperature, 5 degrees centigrade, so what will happen? I'm getting ethylene, I'm getting methane, I'm getting hydrogen. The 2 moles of ethylene, 2 moles of methane, and hydrogen I'm getting. Suppose if I take still higher number, 2 moles of propane, I'm getting propene, I'm getting ethylene, I'm getting methane, and hydrogen. So larger molecule will yield more complex mixture. So if the molecular weight is going on increasing, it will be still complication will be there. This is the interesting information regarding pyrolysis or cracking. This is the another most important chemical property. The next one, another most important property under the isomerization. What is isomerization? Isomerization is a process by which one isomer will be converted into another isomer. Specifically here, generally the alkane RCH2CH2CH3 in presence of aluminium chloride and the HCl converted into RCHCH3CH3 isoalkane. So specifically, let me take now N-butane CH3CH2CH2CH3 in presence of aluminium chloride and HCl, when you heat, it is isomerized into isobutane. So N-butane will be converted into isobutane. This is the specific example of isomerization. One isomer, this is a chain isomer. N-butane and isobutane are chain isomer. So one isomer, the normal chain will be converted into the branched chain. This is coming under the isomerization. The next one. The most important is aromatization, another most important property, chemical property. Under the aromatization, kindly follow me, basically I am taking an NHCl, 6 carbon atom, because the minimum 6 carbon required for aromatization for the healthy example. So, in presence of chromium oxide and aluminium oxide at higher temperature and 10 to 20 atmosphere, I am getting benzene and along with the 4 moles of hydrogen. So, NHCl undergo aromatization to produce benzene. The same N-leptane will give the corresponding toluene, methyl benzene. These two important reactions are specifically after the aromatization. So suitable alkanes, if you use, you will get corresponding higher aromatic isotope. This is the most important information under the aromatization. Now next, let me discuss some of the uses. I will tell specifically first two members. One is methane. So methane is very useful, number one, as a domestic fuel. Number two, it is used for the preparation of methyl chloride, ethylene chloride, chloroform, carbon tetrachloride, formaldehyde, methanol, etc. The second number, ethane, it is also used as a domestic fuel. Additional to this, it is also used for the preparation of chloroethanes. So these are the important uses under this alkane. The next one more topic I have to discuss under this is conformation. This is the most important topic to be discussed under the alkanes. What is conformation? Compounds having same molecular formula but a different spatial arrangement due to carbon-carbon single bond rotation are called conformers, and the phenomenon exhibited by this conformer is called conformation. This is the most important information. So, under the conformation, ethane shows two conformations, propane shows two conformations, and N-butane shows four conformations. So let me give you the suitable structure, you can enter. So this is the Fischer projection. If you want to understand different types of projection, kindly go my lecture, that is, you can have an idea. So under this, ethane, so this is the Fischer projection. So that can be represented by the numerical two ways. This is called Neumann projection for ethane. This is called again Neumann projection for ethane. So one is called eclipse, another is called stagger. Eclipse means hydrogen hydrogen facing each other. Stagger means they are just away from maximum distance away from each other. So this is left side is eclipse form, right side is staggered form. This is two conformation possible for ethane. The same thing for propane again. So this is the Fischer projection. So it will exist in two forms. One is eclipse form, another is staggered form, represented by Neumann projection. So for propane. So propane exists in two forms. So coming for butane, so this is the structure of butane. So in butane, what we have to view is we have to take these two atoms, C2 and C3 we have to view, then we'll get now four conformations are possible. Kindly just look at the Neumann. So number one is eclipsed form, and the number two is staggered form. Number two staggered. Again, number three, kindly see here. So number three again eclipsed. Number four again staggered. Then number five eclipsed, and number six staggered. So there are six conformations possible, but among these six, the 2 and 6 are identical, 3 and 5 are identical. So only 4 conformations are possible in this. Kindly see here. So 2 and 6, so kindly look, just look at here, 6. So now I will go for the 2, you kindly see it is identical. So this is 2. So this 2, and just compare with now 6, then it is identical. That is identical. So 2 and 6 identical. Same with just compare 5, it is identical with 3. Kindly follow. So this 3 and 5 are identical. So only 4 conformation is possible. So one is fully eclipsed, fully staggered. The fully staggered is called anti-conformation. So number 4 is the anti-conformation. This is the anti-conformations, fully staggered. So all the remaining you will use called as skew. That is the most important information. So N-Newton has 4 conformations is possible. That is one more before completing my lecture. So let me take cycloalkane also. So cyclohexane also shows conformation. This is cyclohexane. So it will exist in two forms. One is a chair form, another is board form. It is also showing now chair and board conformation. So this is the most important information under this. I hope you have enjoyed the lecture. Thank you.